my studies. I write a paper about Caravaggio, and therefore I had it in my mind. And in 1998, I got with pupil to the to Naples and to the museum where one of the paintings of Caravaggio, or Caravage in French, were and there was, and I see the painting, and there were two number and two year numbers, 1607 and 1610, and I asked me why these two numbers, and I told one of the heads of the museum why, and he told me that Caravage came back to Naples and was painting one other man on this painting. It's the the painting called The Flagellation of Christ, and this man he painted was a face who came on several paintings of Caravage, and therefore I had in my mind I have to tell a story about this face and this man, with what that is to do with Caravage, and what's the mystery behind this, because we know that Caravaggio take to paint people, they take it from the from outside, social basic people, and not he make no pre-paintings for his faces, and therefore it's mysterious why always the same man came in this painting in 1605, 1606, 1607, 1608, 1609, and also 1610. The new painting of Caravaggio he did with dark and light, and the main sense of a of his paintings are light out with a new form of light, very clear, very direct, and it's I think the most and interesting form of painting in this time. First time I take the true story, and I make a storyboard, and I have to look what I have to take in the novel, and what things I can put out, because I can't write everything. It's in a novel. It's not can't do it. And then I look where is the gap between the real story and the next real story. And this gap I fill with my fantasy. And sometimes the interest is that if you begin to fill it with fantasy, with your ideas, some connections became clear. So the very interesting point of writing novels, that you can take the gaps and make sense to stories.